Hey, I'm Tank, the Coyote. Some of you know me. I've seen that picture, and I immediately knew the real story. Every coyote in the land knows the real story. I can just see old Todd sitting on the front porch with his Rock River in his hands and a big old pile of empty beer cans strewn on the wooden deck, ready to tell the masses yet another Texican yarn about the night it was raining coyotes. A hush falls over the crowd a couple of minutes before he starts to speak. The only sound was the occasional snap of a green bean as his beautiful wife dutifully fills a glass mixing bowl neatly placed upon her lap. She, too, stopped for a moment and gently wiped her hands on her red and white checkered apron trimmed in lace. Todd began with a phrase that all Texicans had learned in their youth as to be a testament of truth. Folks, listen up. Once upon a time long ago in a land this side of the Pecos, he pauses and a low gasping sound started at one end, receding across the crowd like a wave at an Oilers game. Todd continues. A cyclone blew into Texas from the north one April morning, and along the way it had picked up a whole mess of them wiry Oklahoma droopers. Another gasp, even louder than the first, rocketed through the crowd like an Okie launching Scud missiles from a 30-30 at a deer. Todd's eyes narrowed as he cocked his head and looked over at his wife. An errant snap of a bean rolled through the crowd like Texas thunder, and one old boy near the front fainted dead away from sheer anticipation. A crooked smile formed at one end of Todd's mouth as he glanced sideways out into the crowded lawn. Up till now, Oklahoma droopers had only been a myth. But Todd was fixing to spill the beans, so to speak. Sitting in his chair with both elbows resting on his knees, he slowly turned to face his audience. They was huddled together like doggies on a moonless night. The crisp air crackled as Todd stood and clenched his fist to the southern sky, shouting. A second cyclone was blowing up from the south, and the two storms was headed for a collision somewhere around the middle of Haskell County. That second storm had sucked up a whole passel of coyotes as it danced across Texas. You could hear the storm a-howling as it came closer and closer. The storm from up north was screaming wild from the north as it crossed the red. You could almost smell wet coyotes fouling the air as Todd's voice rang out. One fellow near the back blurted out, "Hey, I heard tell of droopers, but they ain't real." By now, Todd's wife had stopped her work and gathered the children in her skirt tails, fearing the worst. A single bolt of lightning flashed across the clear Texas sky, lending proof that the story was true. "Oh, it's real, all right, folks. Fun stuff." Three more Texicans passed out, and the children covered their ears as Todd drew in a big old deep breath. "I saw the storms coming, and that's when I called my buddy White. Then I called up Jeff and told him to quit womanizing and get the camera and gun over here, quick-like. And don't you dare stop to chase any of those danged armadillos along the way." Them Texicans knew about Jeffrey's fondness for chasing armadillos and turned to each other and nodding their heads. Todd pulled on a half-empty beer, wiped his chin on his shirt sleeve and said, "Them fishermen boys ain't never seen what a perfect storm really is." Within 10 minutes, Jeff pulled up the drive and all three piled in with Todd yelling, "I got shotgun! I ain't the bitch!" That's coyote talk for female. "Hit the county road and let's meet those storms in the middle." The race was on. "Turn north on 2163 and haul ass to 160. The storms were closing in, and about 200 yards from 2163, Jeff flipped the turn signal, which was rare. When he did, a clap of thunder let loose and he swerved on the shoulder thinking he blew a tire. White bounced off of Jeff and over to Todd, and Todd hollered, "Get off me, you pervert!" Jeff hit 2163 doing 40 miles an hour and somehow made the turn. "Hurry up!" The storm was passing them. It sounded like a freight train heading for hell. 160 came up too fast, and Jeff didn't make the turn. Instead, they flew across the bar ditch and stopped on the edge of a hay grazer field. Directly in front of them, the two storms collided, causing a huge, thunderous boom with lightning flashes everywhere. The concussion flattened the hay grazer, flatter than a roadkill. Todd grabbed a video camera, White grabbed a rifle, and Jeff grabbed himself. All three jumped into the truck bed to get a better view. When the ground quit shaking from the collision, Jeff saw something falling from the sky. They could hear thuds from whatever it was hitting the ground. The lightning was constant now, and they could see human forms rising to their feet. They was tall, skinny, droopy, and naked. The storm collision had done knocked off whatever clothes they was a-wearing. There must have been more than 100. They was the scariest things that ever walked on 3 legs. Then more things started falling out of the clouds. It was coyotes! Hundreds of them! One landed in the arms of one of the droopers, who let out a big grin, tucked it under one arm, and headed for the hardwoods, with 3 more droopers in hot pursuit. Everywhere a coyote ran, it run smack dab into a drooper, who'd snatch it up and run for the hardwoods. The only direction there weren't no droopers was south, towards the truck. Todd saw him coming and told Jeff to get loaded and in the tower. They didn't need a spotlight because of all the lightning. "I'm rolling," hollered Todd. "Get to shooting. Here comes 3 on the left. Bang, bang, bang. 4 coming on the right. I'm on them. Take them. Incoming. 12 o'clock. Straight at us." The bad thing was, Jeff couldn't stay on the coyote and jerked the trigger, missing it at 6 feet. The good thing was that the coyote never saw the 33-inch monster mudder tires he run into and bounced 4 feet backwards, breaking his neck. "1 off left. 2 to the right. I'm on the 2. Take them. I'm out. I need a clip. I need a clip." 8 got through. Bang, bang. 2 more went down. 4 more passed. White mist, turning a coyote back, and it ran into a drooper, who snatched it up, hollering, "I got myself a purty one." The storm started dying out as the sun come up, giving way to a crimson sunrise. Coyotes could be heard yipping deep in the hardwoods. Todd paused and reached for another beer, and 6 Texicans gang-tackled an Okie, wandering aimlessly through the crowd. Everyone else was waiting for Todd to finish his story. Then he placed his beer down and rose to his feet. "I was 400 yards away when them 2 cyclones hit. 3 of us seen it. 3 of us seen it rain coyotes. And we seen Oklahoma droopers, too. If it hadn't rained them coyotes, we'd all been bitches. We loaded the truck with all the coyotes we could find. We tried talking Jeff into looking in the hardwoods for a few, but he said even an armadillo wouldn't cause him to go near them. All told, we got 34 coyotes. The night, it rained coyotes. Oh yeah, we ran over a bobcat on the way home.